Welcome once again to Douglas Ebola TV, a station like no other, where we throw punches straight up your face, no sugarcoating, no editorial restriction, giving you the real deal so you can deal with it. Now let's get on with it. Sweet baby Jesus! You want to start a business? You want to buy a home? You want to invest in security or other investments? And you're a minority? Look no further, for there are 38 black-owned banks and cooperatives in America. Yeah, that's right. 38 black-owned banks and cooperatives in America. How many people knew that? I'm sure majority of the people did not. And 19 out of these are fully-fledged banks that have been operating since 2018. Some have been there way back in the 1960s, some have been there way back in the 1970s, and I shall go deeper into it. But the reason why I'm bringing this topic up is, majority of the time, most people want to invest their money in businesses. Most people want to borrow capital so that they can invest in a business. Most people want to, you know, borrow some money so that they can invest in their homes or, you know, expand their homes or even buy other properties. Newer properties and expand their investment. And some, you know, just they would like to borrow to invest their money in securities and shares and see the investment grow. And, you know, most of these transactions are normally carried out in banks whereby you're given loans or the credit unions, they're able to offer you loans. Well, that is a part if you have a rich cousin or a rich dad, he can loan you the money. But majority of the people actually go to these institutions to actually get this funding. And this is the reason why I was touching on this topic, because we are talking about investing in the community. And when we talk about investing in the community, we're talking about the black community. How do we invest back in the black community? And in this particular point, I'm looking at black-owned banks. That's right. I'm looking at black-owned banks in America. There are 38 credit unions and banks that are black owned in America. 19 of these are fully fledged banks. And I'll touch on the biggest five banks that are available for you. That if you're a minority, if you're African American, if you're from Africa, these are black owned banks that you can invest in and you can expect to be treated well. You can expect to be given or accorded certain facilities that you might lack somewhere else. And the reason why I'm touching on this is not because I'm trying to separate black or white. The reason why I'm saying this is that you have to also invest in community businesses that will also help you, you know, at the long run, give back to the community and also help your community. Because this is not rocket science. This is just smart thinking. You have to invest in your own businesses too, okay? So that as they grow, they also help the community. I'll touch on the five biggest banks, starting from number one, which is the biggest. That is One United Bank, which was formed in 1968. And it has $661 million in assets, followed by Liberty Bank and Trust, which was established in 1972, which has about $594 million in assets, followed by number three, Citizens Trust Bank, which was formed in 1921 and has $399 million in assets. The fourth one is Industrial Bank, which was formed in 1934 and has about $423 million in assets. And the fifth one is the Harbor Bank of Maryland, which was formed in 1982 and has about $266 million in assets. Well, you might look at these banks and compare with them with Chase Bank and compare with some like Bank of America, but you know, in comparison, yes, Chase Bank or Bank of America, their asset base, their asset worth is a lot of money. It might run into trillions. But what we are talking about is that you have this community-owned black banks that are actually out there that we can actually invest our money in there, in these banks, and we can increase their asset base, and we can be able to grow these banks into big banks that are able to actually help and service the community. And the reason why I'm saying this is, you know, by investing or saving your money and dealing with this black-owned banks, what happens is that the banks also give back. And how do they give back? One, they give back in terms of employment. These are creating opportunities for black minorities to be able to be employed in this in these banks, opportunities which sometimes you may not get in other big banks. It helps support community organizations, the organizations that are in the community, helping the community in case on different aspects of issues affecting the community. These banks give back in terms of their corporate social responsibility, and they give back to the community. So the more you invest in this bank, the more the community is engaged with this bank, then the banks will also give back as a form of appreciation to the community. And this helps and strengthens the community. They also support education in the community. Through the CSR programs, this is a corporate social responsibility. These banks also help support education in the community in all aspects. Talk about building schools, talk about renovating schools, talk about helping coming up with new structures in education that will actually help the community go forward. These banks will able to do that. If we invest in them, the more we invest in them, the more they can do for the community, the more they can be able to actually give back to the community. And also, we also find that these banks also help support social amenities in terms of isn't renovating parks, in terms of providing new social amenities like movie theaters, basketball courts, you know, in terms of providing malls, things that actually help improve the community standards of living. So the more we invest in businesses that are minority owned, the more we have a chance of those businesses actually giving back to the community and helping the community in very many ways imaginable that is such a beneficial to the community. We also have these banks that also help support community growth in terms of the community growing and solidarity of the community. When we bank with them, we establish a relationship of solidarity, which gives us a unity of purpose. At the same time, they also support and build community pride, as well as support community in legal, social, economic decisions in the country. There are other benefits that come from investing in these black banks as a way of helping to grow the community and also helping to have to give the community a voice in terms of financial status and in terms of access to finance, because we know finance actually is you know, the lubricant to everything. So if we can be able to access finance, you can be able to do more. And why not invest in our black-owned banks that are there in America? And I've told you the five big ones, as well as there are more. So in total, there are 38 banks and credit unions. And most of the time, the credit unions, when they grow, they can actually move in and become banks. And, you know, we expect maybe in future to have some mergers in terms of these big banks. They might merge, come together, be bought out, and, you know, create one or three big banks that can be able to serve the black community and can be able to help the black community in so many ways imaginable. So let's invest in our businesses. So this particular time I was just concentrating on the banks, but I've always talked about also investing in black businesses as a critical and very fundamental thing in terms of helping the community grow and helping the community be able to be appreciated and respected. Because if other businesses don't respect you and you don't have your own businesses that you can go to and support, then, you know, you kind of like still have to go to those other businesses despite the disrespect. But if you grow your own businesses, you can be able to get the respect that you deserve, and you can be treated and you can be given worth of your money in terms of when you invest in this business. So go check out, do your own research about these banks, Google them, check them out. If you can be able to visit them, go in, ask questions. You'll be getting a lot of information from them. You know, just see the impact, what are they doing for the community and what they can be able to do. Ask these questions to these banks. Let them know that you're interested, you're engaged to know what they do. And just find out that how are they impacting the community. And you can imagine if every person invests in this banks in terms of a savings account. You can still have an account with another bank, but if you also invest some money in these black-owned banks, we can be able to grow the black-owned banks to be very powerful and be very, very instrumental in terms of helping build the community up and also help the community in terms of access to finance that can help them in their everyday endeavors and make life easy. So that's it for today from Douglas Ebola TV. I just wanted to touch on this. There's so much to talk about these black banks and what they're doing and their impact on the society. But I just wanted to highlight this so that people can be aware that we have 38 black-owned banks and credit unions in America that are there to serve you. Invest in them as an African-American or an African, and you can be able to see the impact that will come to you and your society and your community. All right? So this is all about empowerment. I'm not discriminating or anything, but you still have to invest in your community. At the end of the day, when things hit the fence, the community stands firm and the community will support you and the community will speak as one and will speak for you. So invest in your community and help your community grow. Thank you very much. Until I see you next time, this is Douglas Ebola TV. Find me Douglas Ebola TV on YouTube, and Douglas Ebola TV on Instagram. All the time trying to give you knowledge, trying to impact you, trying to create a situation whereby I can help you critically think and I can be able to share information. I don't have all the answers, but I try to share as much as I can so that you can be able to engage me and ask me questions. Let me know what you think. Subscribe to my channels and let's grow. Let's educate each other and let's stay positive. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.